It's March 21st, 2024. We're at the World Health Organization. I'm here with Gopakumar, and we're talking about the negotiations on a pandemic agreement. Gopa, could you start out by telling people who you are, who you represent, why you're here for the negotiation, how things are gone, have gone so far, and what advice you have for the negotiators?
Jamie, I'm Gopakumar. I work with the Third World Network. As most of you know, that Third World Network is a not-for-profit organization. It carries out research and advocacy around various international development issues, including health. So I am here to represent Third World Network, which is part of a following this process since 2021 onwards. And we are closely watching this this negotiating process, and our primary interest is that how this agreement is going to address the current inequities in the international health emergency regime. So from we have been following all the negotiations around this particular instrument, and this is the ninth round of negotiations happening in Geneva from March 18 to 28. It is supposed to be the last round, but at the same time, this is the first round where actually member states are engaged in a formally text-based negotiations. So we are here how the negotiations are progressing and how the negotiations are leading to a direction where it is going to, whether it's going to fulfill its promise of addressing equity and equitable access in the case of health emergencies.
What is what advice do you have for the negotiators this week?
So it's not of an advice, but it's kind of an appeal to the negotiators. They should look at all proposal from a most important perspective, most important, not a perspective, but I would say the most important litmus test they should apply every proposal is that how it is going to change the status quo for a better world. And a world which people can have equitable access or affordable access to vaccines, therapeutics, diagnostics, or any other products which is required to respond to a health emergency, including a pandemic. So that should be the test. And as of now, we do not have any sustained and predictable guarantee of access on any of the health products, so that we have seen during the COVID, and therefore the negotiators' primary effort should to change the status quo and to ensure that we should not end up in a same situations like COVID. In case of another pandemic or a health emergency, which may which may appears on Earth in the future.
What if anything has surprised you this week?
What it's not a surprise, but I am realizing that apart from the top line statements, or even apart from the promise, when it comes to closer to the realities, the real politic is coming out, and most of the countries who are having the abilities to respond positively to change the status quo are now stepping back from their promise and much more interested to protect their commercial and strategic interest rather than protecting the larger public interest of humanity. Because I consider, or the Third World Network for that matter, consider preparedness and response to a pandemic is a global public good. And it should be available to all the needy countries and the people at an affordable price, or as a public good, free of cost. But I think that is becoming a distant dream So that worries me.
How optimistic are you that the agreement will be concluded by May?
I think I am eternally optimistic, because optimism at this moment is required. Otherwise, we will be, reinforcing or will be part of reinforcing the forces, of status quo. So I don't want to align with them. So I would always be optimistic and try to push that small, even if it's a small inch, I'll be with those people who push that for the change.
Thank you very much. Is there anything you'd like to add before we conclude? We're good?
I remain optimistic. That's it. And I appeal everybody to be optimistic and try hard to change the status quo.
Thank you.
Thanks.